Right, so let us start the next topic, hypocycloids. So previous lectures we have completed cycloids and epicycloids. Now hypocycloids. So hypocycloids means when a circle is rolling inside of another circle without slipping. When a circle is rolling inside of another circle without slipping, the curve obtained is cycloidal curve. See, this is one circle, this is our directing circle, okay, larger one is directing circle and this is rolling circle. When a circle moves from here to here, right, this is the point of intersection, this is the point of intersection, we have to find out the angle theta. So theta equal to, we know the formula, small r by capital R into 360 degrees. Right, small r is nothing but radius of rolling circle and capital R is nothing but radius of directing circle. Same how we constructed epicycloids, same process we are going to construct in hypocycloids. But the main difference is, in epicycloids, outside of directing circle, we are drawing rolling circle. Here, inside of directing circle, we should draw rolling circle. It is the main difference. So let us see the problem. Draw a hypocycloid of a circle of 40 mm diameter which rolls inside of another circle of diameter 200 mm for one revolution. And also draw tangent and normal at a point of 30 mm from baseline. Now you see here, instead of hypocycloid, if suppose they mention cycloid. Draw a curve, cycloidal curve of a circle of 40 mm diameter which rolls inside of another circle. See, you have to remember one thing. In question, if they didn't mention to draw epicycloid, or in question if they didn't mention to draw hypocycloid, right, you have to remember one terms like outside external contact is epicycloid, inside internal contact is hypocycloid, right? So in question, instead of epicycloids, hypocycloids, if they mention outside external contact, inside internal contact, so please see the terms, right? Here they mention inside. Inside means we have to construct hypocycloid, right? See, rolling circle diameter is 40, directing circle diameter is 200. So we have to find the angle. No, theta equal to small r by capital R into 360 degrees. So 20 by 100 into 360 degrees. So here I got here 72. Right. So for epicycloids and for hypocycloids, you should calculate theta value first. Right. Same process. See, keep your protractor in straight manner. First of all, mark the 90 degrees line, 0 degrees line, right? First, draw a straight line of any length. Draw a straight line of any length. Okay, after that, the angle is 72. 72 by 2, 36 degrees, right? So, if suppose I'm taking point O here, keep your protractor on this line from O point. Keep your protractor on this line from O. This is 0, right? So you should mark here 36. Mark 36 degrees and again turn your protractor. Keep your protractor on that line from O point. Again mark here 36. Right? Now, from this O point, I will draw a straight line. I will draw a straight line of 36 degrees angle. Of length how much? Of length how much? 100 mm. Radius 100 mm. Right? First we have to draw the radius of rolling circle. Right? So first I am constructing from O. I am constructing 100 mm line. Right, so I'm taking this point as P. Right, first draw your vertical line 90 degrees, then keep your protractor here, take 36 degrees here, keep your protractor here, take 36 degrees here. Now I'm naming this point as O. From O, draw a line which is equal to radius of directing circle. radius of directing circle is here 100 mm. So I'm constructing 100 mm, right? Inside you should mark rolling circle. Okay, in question they mention inside, no? So hypocycloids means you have to mark the rolling circle inside. Suppose if you are constructing epicycloids, from P you are taking radius and you are drawing the circle outside, right? Here hypocycloids means you have to mark inside, right? Diameter is 40. If diameter is 40, radius is 20, right? So mark 20 mm radius, name this point as C. Inside you have to mark. If epi, you have to mark outside. Hypo, you have to mark inside. This is the major difference between epi and hypo, right? So C as center, CP as radius, draw the circle. Right, now you know how to divide this circle into 12 equal parts. Anyway, I got this line now. So I'm keeping my protractor on this line. C as center, 0, 30, 60, 90, 120, 150. Right, so I'm dividing into 12 equal parts. Each unit is a 30 degrees angle. Now this is the P point. Give numbers in anti-clockwise direction. Right, after that what we have to do? Keep your compass at O point. Right, O to P, draw a curve. Right, and join this one. This is 36 degrees now. Right, afterwards again with O as center, join this 1 and 11, draw a curve. Again join this 2 and 10, draw the curve. Again join this 3 and 9, draw a curve. See, you have to place your protractor at O point only. Again join this 4 and 8, right? Join this here 5 and 7, right? Join this 6th point. At last, from center of the circle also you have to mark, no? So this is the center of the circle, draw this one, right? After that, extend this perpendicular line to this middle line. Right, now this is 36 degrees and this is 36 degrees. Right, so I should divide this into 6 equal parts, this into 6 equal parts. So first I am placing my protractor on that line, O point. So 36, no? 36 by 6. So each is 6 degrees. 6 1 is 6, 6 2 is 12. 6 3 is 18, 6 4 is 24, 6 5 is 30. Zero, one, two, three, four, five, six, 36. Right? 6 6 36. Then next again place your protractor on that line. Right? So 6 12 18 24 30 and 36. 6 table. Right, now join all these lines, join all these points. right? So this is center of circle, and next is C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, C8, C9, C10, C11 and C12. Right? Now how to construct the cycloidal curve? Take radius of circle, C1 as center. Draw the arc on first line. This is the first point, first line. Draw the arc on first line. C2 as center, draw the arc on second line. C2 point, second line. C3 as center, draw the arc on third line. Third point, third arc. C4 as center, fourth line. C5 as center, fifth line. C6 as center. If you draw, you will get the curve here, C6. C7 as center, C8 as center, C9, C10, C11 and C12. See, if you are drawing the 12th arc, see, 12th point, 12th arc. Right? After that, name these points. P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, P9, P10, P11 and P12. Right? If you join all this, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, P9, P10, P11, P12. You will get the hypocycloidal curve. Right? After that, you have to draw tangent and normal. So, how to construct tangent and normal? 30 mm from baseline. See, wherever P point is located, that line is baseline. Here P point is located, so this one is our baseline. Keep your scale in vertical manner. Exactly 0 should touch on this baseline and see where 30 mm meets on the curve. Right, see here, 0 is touching on this baseline and P is touching, 30 is touching on this curve. So I am taking this as point P. Right, so after marking point P, what we have to do, take radius of circle with compass, keep your compass on P point, draw the arc on the middle line. Right, now from this arc, draw a straight line to this baseline. Right, and join this point and P point. Right, this is your normal. Exactly perpendicular to normal is tangent. So N dash T dash. Right, so this completes your problem. Marking dimensions is very important. Right, now draw the extension line. Right, draw the extension line. O2P distance is 100 mm, no? So draw the dimensional line, closed and filled arrow marks, here radius 100. Right, after that they mention diameter of circle also. Right, so this is the diameter of circle. Draw the extension line, right, dimensional line, closed and filled arrow marks, diameter is here pi 40 mm. Always you should mark the larger dimensions outside and smaller dimensions inside. Right, and then next, tangent to normal distance. Draw the extension line, dimensional line 30 mm. Right, so this is how to construct hypocycloids. After completion, write down here. Take height 5 mm and write down here hypocycloid. Right, so let us see the next one, last one. So this is the question. Construct a hypocycloid taking the diameter of rolling circle and radius of directing circle as 60 mm. What they mentioned here, diameter of rolling circle, diameter of rolling circle is 60 mm and radius of directing circle is 60 mm. calculate. So let us calculate theta equal to small r by capital R into 360 degrees. So small r is, diameter is 60. So radius is 30. Small r by capital R. Anyway, they mentioned r only. By 60 into 360 degrees. So you are getting angle here 180 degrees. 180 degrees means straight line. 180 degrees means straight line. So how to construct this one? First they mentioned diameter of rolling circle is 60 mm. So if diameter is 60 mm, radius will be 30 mm. Right? So take 30 mm radius with compass. First construct the circle. First construct the circle. Right? This is diameter of rolling circle. Then next, radius of directing circle is 60 mm. Now from the end point, take 60 mm line. Take 60 mm line. This is radius of directing circle. Here theta is 180 degrees now, so that's why I'm drawing in a straight manner. 180 degrees straight manner, right? So this is the midpoint C, right? Now I am dividing this circle into 12 equal parts. And this point is O, this point is C, and this point is P. In hypocycloids, always we are going to mark P point here. Because outside we are not marking any circle. Inside only we are marking circle, no? So P point will be almost the topmost point. So I am writing P point here. Give numbers in anti-clockwise direction. P point is your 12th point. Right. After that, same process, keep your compass at O point, right, O to P. Draw the line, it should touch the end point. Then next from O to join this 1 and 2. Sorry, join 1 and 11. Right, then next join here 2 and 10. Right, then next join here 3 and 9. Right, then next join here 2 and 4 and 8. Right, again from this point join here 5 and 7. Difficult to join this one. Join 5 and 7. After that, after joining all these two points, you should draw from center of the circle also, right? So O as center, C as radius, join the middle one. See, in this problem, from O as center, OC radius, same you will get the arc on 4-8 only. You are keeping a compass here, you are joining these two points, no, 4 and 8. Right? If you take radius from O to C also, you will get the same curve on that 4, 8 only. Right? After that, you have to divide this total 180 into 12 equal parts, no. So keep your protractor on this line, 180 degrees. Right? So 180 by 12. 180 degrees we are dividing into 12 equal parts. So each unit is 15 degrees. 15, 30, 45, 60, 75, 90. Same. 15, 30, 45, 60, 75, 90. I am dividing 180 into 12 equal parts and I am drawing all these lines now. I'm dividing this 180 degrees into 12 equal parts. Right? Now, this is to the center of the circle, no? So, naming it as here C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, C8, C9, C10, C11, and this is to a C12. Right? Now, how to construct the arc? Same method. O to P radius. Take radius of circle. C1 as center. This is the first line. No? I will get the first arc here. C2 as center. Second arc. C3 as center. Third arc. C4 as center. Fourth arc. C5 as center. Fifth arc. C6 as center. See, this is the sixth point. C6 as center. We will get the arc here. C7 as center. Seventh one. C8 as center. C9 as center. Right? So you will get all the curves in straight manner. C9, C10, C11 and C12. Right? You will get all the curves in straight manner. See, this is the 10th. See, this is the first arc. It will touch here. This is the second arc. It is touching here. Third arc, fourth arc, fifth arc, sixth arc. So all the arcs is touching on the same line. Right? So name it as here P, P1. P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, P9, P10, P11 and P12. Right? If you join all this, you will get a straight line. This is the hypocycloidal curve. What is the condition? Diameter of rolling circle and the radius of directing circle as same. Right? So in this question they mention only what they mentioned. They mention diameter of rolling circle, they mention radius of directing circle. So draw the dimensional line, closed and filled arrow marks. This is diameter 60 mm, this is radius 60 mm. Right? Diameter, radius, when both are same, this is the constructional method to solve the problem. So till here we completed cycloidal curves, right? So please remember one point: cycloids, when a circle is rolling along a straight line, it is cycloids. When a circle is rolling outside of another circle, external contact is epicycloids. When a circle is rolling inside of another circle, internal contact is hypocycloids. Right? So all the problems are in similar manner we have to construct, but be careful while marking the points and drawing the arcs.